Yo guys, and welcome back to another video on the Bastard channel.
In this survival episode, we're gonna tour the base again, show you a little bit behind the scenes what we did, updates and stuff. We did quite a lot, not as much as last episode, because that was over a period of 2 weeks, but yeah, this is over a period of 1 week, of course. So I'm gonna show you around the base, show you what we have done, and the footage for that, and how we have done it and stuff. We did a lot of crazy stuff this week. We made a sand duper. The slime farm is way more efficient now. It's not done yet, but it's gonna be more efficient. And yeah, just a lot more management and sorting of the items and stuff. So let's check that out. You can see a little preview of the island right now. I'm gonna go in detail what we did this week and explain you what we are going to do different the next episode, because I don't really like this style, but I can't really change it right now because I only have footage after we built it. So yeah, let's jump right into this episode. Right, so we start off in the room under our base, and we made a sorting system here for all our different farms. So I'm gonna go into that. We have a huge water and packed ice system under our base that connects most of the farms. We didn't do all of them yet, but we're gonna do that shortly. For example, the sugarcane farm is hooked up. But yeah, so the iron farm has tubes and bubble vaders and stuff going to the ice bath tunnels all the way back to the storage system. It's also for the skeleton farm, and I think the wood and cobble farms also hooked up. And I think that's all. So that goes through the ice into this bubble elevator into the sorting system, just standard sorting system. And then for the poppies from the IG farm, we dispense them in a composter that makes bone meal, and so get a little bit of bone meal out of that. Then we have a villager that we got from our little holding shell over here. And he is armor, so we can trade in iron for emeralds. And we have a lot of iron, as you can see. Double chest of blocks and stuff is way too much, so easy way to make emeralds. Then we also built a little nano farm for the bread to give to the villagers to breed them, nice, tucked in this corner, and a super big auto smelter, as you can see. Yeah, quite big. It has, I think, 64 furnaces, maybe even more, so we can smelt a stack of items in the same time as it would take one furnace to smelt one item. So pretty quick, took a lot of work, and the fuel is coming from carpet duper, so dupers are allowed on the server. I don't know why I can't see the carpets, but should be fine. So yeah, the system gets its fuel from carpets and smelts the items with the carpets and dispenses them right here into the water stream, into this chest. So we can smelt a lot of items. Then we have the real duper, nothing different here. We also are holding a lot of bees. They're not all right here, but we made a little bee farm. Wait, there's a bee stuck in between. Okay, so yeah, we have a bee farm that's right over here. Bippy built this bee farm. It works quite well. I think he emptied it, but yeah, we have a lot of honey blocks now, and we needed that for the tree farm. We don't have a tree farm building montage because it was a lot of trouble, and yeah, TNT dupers didn't really work, so we had to design our own duper, and yeah, it wasn't that easy, but it works now. We later built a cobble farm onto it, so you will see that right now, just quick little time lapse of me building a cobble farm on the other side of this TNT duper. Bippy also built this sugarcane farm, I think we don't have footage of that because he started building when he wasn't online or something, or was it around? So yeah, we built the sugarcane farm. It's quite big, not as efficient, but we'll work on that to make it more efficient. We do have some footage from me helping planting the sugarcane. Yeah, I helped with that, so you can see that right here. Planted some sugarcane, and while Whippy was building the rest of the redstone dropper systems and hopper minecart stuff. So yeah, super quick time lapse of me planting sugarcane. And we also removed the sugarcane, the temporary sugarcane farm, between our iron farm design. So yeah, that was already it. Let's go to the next thing. And foster. So that's one thing we need to do. And then we had a pretty big project right over here. As you can remember, the slime farm. It's not done right now. We need to patch up these caves. But every cave is lighted up with torches. Except this big ravine, because why bother? So the slime farm will be more efficient because all the caves are lighted up. And we removed all the blocks. I have some footage of that right now. So in this little time lapse, I want to give a big shout out to Fraggin Masters, because we agreed that if he gave him a shout out, then he would give us a shout out. So if you're interested in that channel, go check it out, by the way. He has a lot of amazing content. Go check out his channel, and yeah. Hope to hear from him that some of our viewers also went there to check that out. In this time lapse, you can see me using 3 TNT dupers to mine out the slime junk. We have 3 TNT dupers on a stationary build right here, but I'm gonna change that to one of those flying machines so I didn't have to pull the pistons along and stuff. You can see here it's on the flying machine, so wasn't that much work. And then I just duped and duped until the whole chunk was cleared out and I could start mining the sides to make it smooth. This took quite a long time. I sped it up 16 times. So yeah, I did 1/4 of that, and then Whippy came online and helped me with the other 3/4. So yeah, between this fourth and the other ones, we also light up the gate, so no mobs can spawn anymore, and disturb the slime farm, because it's way more efficient if you don't have blocks above the slime farm, and all the caves are light up. So yeah, we did. As you can see, we removed all the blocks with TNT dupers and stuff. We need to fix the farm down here. Yeah, everything is removed, but I think this looks way nicer and it's also a lot more efficient. And yeah, we also trolled Thijsje once. We tried to troll him with the trap by this door, but it didn't really work. And he glitched out and fell down. And yeah, we don't really count glitch deaths as real deaths, so we removed that one. Removed the trap because he noticed, of course. And yeah. But we got him once in the nether. I will show you that right now. As you can see, I trapped Thijsje in our portal trap with lava. I broke the portal so he couldn't escape. He died. But he tried to escape first. Placed the block and then he died. Sonnetje also tried to trap us. Or me. That didn't really work. I saw it was a trap immediately. Just look at the big box. Of course it's a trap. So it was standing between the chest and the block. So on the little ledge. So I didn't fall down. Then later I lured Sandertje into the trap. So yeah, you can see me here discovering it was a trap. Then I lured Sandertje in to look in the chest and stand on the ledge. But before he was there, I opened the chest and he fell down. He didn't die, but I thought it was pretty funny. As you can see, we got him in the nether, once with the lava and stuff. We also have some changes to how we get stuff. And by stuff, I of course mean sand. So let's go to our personal stronghold and we'll show you the
stone machine right here. And this is used to dupe sand. We don't have any sand in there right now, but I think there should be some here.
No, but yeah, we used it a little bit and it broke because the old lockdown and stuff. So we need to fix that. But if we go to the end, there we go. You can see a lot of sand right there. Do I have my Elytra on? Yes, I do. Let's fly over to the farm. Please land. No. Maybe I can just jump down from here. There we go. Hoppers are stacked. Okay. So, the end also wasn't loaded. So, yeah. So, the sand from the duper flies from the obsidian platform with some momentum from slime blocks right in here into the catcher that breaks the sand with this lever and just goes down into the chest. So, I'm going to take a little bit of sand with me because I don't want to go here again. Get it. What did we do? I think we did a little bit of end raiding, not that much. So here you can see us building the machine. We did this together, and because the stronghold is underwater in the ocean somewhere, had a little bit of difficulty with the redstone because water was coming in and stuff, and we also messed something up with the pistons, but yeah, we got it in the end. Didn't take that long, just some repeated settings and stuff for Rob. And yeah, Vippy already removed some of the portal blocks with one of those big mushrooms. And yeah, that's how we got our sand duper. So let's go through the end portal and see where all of that sand lands up on the end side. Thijs' and Sondage's base. We don't have skills anymore. He had to do way too much homework and stuff. So he left and Sondage is gonna replace him. He's a lot more active. They did way more than in the first 2 weeks. They have a villager system. They have automatic sorting system, same as us. And a little automatic smelter, but they had it already, I think. Still have the portal on the mushroom. Same. They have a tree farm, also the same as us. And the same iron farm as us. And they have a little villager breeder, but we just use our nano farm to get bone meal for, to get bread for the villager farm. So we don't really need this. Or something. Some of the villagers escaped. Then we have, let's see, they have some farms in the Nether, like a bee farm, and they have also a bamboo farm. Well, not bamboo, this is sugarcane farm. And they don't really have any other farms on this island, as you can see them right now. They don't have a slime farm. So we're ahead with that. But yeah, our slime farm is broken, so that's also no good. But yeah, they even copied our technique with the chains and stuff and the glass panes above the villagers. So yeah, this is almost exactly the same as we did. Yeah, this is just the same. They don't have automatic sorting, yes. So we have systems to bring the iron from our farm to the sorting system. They don't have that yet. But I'm pretty sure they will copy that also. So just a matter of waiting. So that was Thijs' and Sander's base. And that was also the end of this episode. So I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.